Some commands are so familiar you don't even notice when you use them anymore. CD is one of them. It stands for change directory, and yes, it's as basic as it gets. And you may think you know kung fu, but I bet I can still show you a couple of tricks that you cannot find in the manual. Also, there is no manual. Welcome to Nick's Tricks. I am Nick, and this is CD. How's it going, guys? For the sake of being thorough, we're gonna start with a quick run through the standard uses of the command. But first, let me address that thing about the manual. CD is a shell built-in command, and that's why it doesn't have its own man page. You can read a little about it using the help command, which is another built-in. And if you want, you can also read about help, but that just makes you look desperate. No matter where you are, when you run CD without any arguments, it takes you to your home directory. This is usually a directory that has your user's name, and it sits under the home directory of your file system's root. Running CD tilde has the same effect because the tilde character, or wave dash, is actually an expansion of your home directory. Using it is a very convenient way of referencing paths that are relative to your home without having to type the entire absolute path or using the home variable. Let's talk a bit about absolute and relative paths now that we warmed up. An absolute path is any path that starts with a slash character, meaning that the path starts from the very root directory of your file system. Any other path is going to be relative to your current working directory or your base path, as we're going to see really soon. Let's say I'm in my home directory and I want to get to documents. I can just CD documents, and it works because documents is in my home. Now, if I wanted to go to downloads, which is one level higher, I could type CD dot dot slash downloads to use a path relative to this one, or CD tilde slash downloads, which is relative to home, but technically counts as an absolute path since the tilde expands into slash home slash nick. One quick word about the mysterious dots that we see in every directory. They are references created by the file system automatically. One dot to reference the current directory, two dots to reference the parent. It's actually similar to how the slash character is a reference to the root directory. The CD command also has an interesting flag, capital P for physical directory, which comes in handy when working with symlinks. It forces the command to change to the actual physical directory that the link is pointing to. If you want to know all about symlinks, hard links, the difference between them and how to use them, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, because that's what my next video is going to be about. Time to look at some cool tricks you can do with CD. The first one is hopping back and forth between two directories. I've also mentioned it in my video about aliases, where we created shortcuts to all sorts of commands, including a bunch of common uses of CD. I recommend checking it if you haven't seen it yet. Next, we have an interesting shorthand for quickly navigating to the last argument of the previous command. So if you ran ls usr local bin, you could use cd bang $ to go directly to usr local bin without having to retype all of it. Here's a fun one. You don't need to type cd at all. There's a way to set a shell option in bash so that anything you type that isn't a command script or other executable, like an alias, will be used as a target directory. You can try it out by using the shopt command, that stands for shell options, with the s flag to set an option or the u flag to unset it. And if you want to make this behavior persistent, you will have to add it to your bash rc. This is a popular feature in Z shell, where, by the way, you can use the set opt and unset opt commands instead. Last but not least, I mentioned the term base path earlier. The shell uses the current working directory as the base directory for relative paths. So anytime you CD into a path that doesn't start with some explicit indicative of whether it's an absolute or relative path, the command will implicitly assume that the path is relative to your current directory. But there's a way to change that, or even add multiple base paths. If you spend most of your time around a certain directory in your file system, you can save a lot of keystrokes with this trick. To achieve this, all we have to do is export cdpath, which is another environmental variable, like path. I'm gonna go ahead and make this persistent already by adding the command to my bash rc. One important thing to note here is that if you set a base directory, it'll also affect any directory changes performed within shell scripts. To avoid this, you can either use absolute paths in all of your scripts or add a simple conditional like this one to your export command. This is another cool little trick to figure out the context by checking if the command prompt variable ps1 has been set. I hope you learned something new and interesting. Let me know in the comments if you can think of any other cool tips about using the cd command. And if you like the video, please make sure to also let YouTube know about it by hitting that like button and all the other nice buttons. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.